If the Treasury Secretary of the United States has one job, it definitely includes not injecting more uncertainty into the economy. So then you be the judge now of what Steve Mnuchin just did. After a weekend of check-in calls with CEOs of the country's largest banks, Mnuchin put out a statement and in part said this, that the CEOs confirmed that they have ample liquidity available to available for lending to consumer, business, markets, and all other market operations. That's great, except for one thing. There wasn't any question that the banks wouldn't be able to meet their obligations, leaving investors and everyone else scratching their heads and wondering, should they now be questioning that? The CEOs themselves reportedly found the whole thing strange, and that, that is maybe what is happening today in the shortened trading session today. But let's find out, actually. Let's go over to CNN business correspondent Allison Kosick. She's taking a look at that. So, Allison, that's Rana. I'm going to talk to Rana in a second. We're going to go to Allison on the floor of the New York Stock Exchange. Allison, what are you seeing there?
I'm seeing a lot of investors, Kate, trying to wrap their heads around why Treasury Secretary Steve Mnuchin made these calls individually, one by one, to these bank CEOs on a Sunday. It's kind of reminiscent during the financial crisis when you had these investment brokers making these liquidity calls on Sunday to preempt the market action on that next Monday. So this is kind of causing some fears here in the market, as you can see playing out here on the Dow down 368 points. If Steve Mnuchin was looking to calm the markets, I would say this was certainly a misfire. CEOs are calling this call totally baffling. They find it puzzling and largely unnecessary because, as they told the secretary, there is no liquidity problem with each of their banks. Now, this can be troublesome for the market because it can cause this panic, because the thinking is, does the Trump administration know that there's something coming that we don't know? So it really amps up that fear that you're seeing play out in the market today. Kate?
That's right, Allison. Thanks so much. We look at the New York Stock Exchange. Joining me right now is the aforementioned Rana Faruhar, CNN Global Economic Analyst, also Global Business Columnist and Associate Editor for the Financial Times. It's great to see you, Rana.
Nice to see you.
So the Democratic Senator, Brian Schatz, he loves to take to Twitter to kind of needle the president. He had this to say about Mnuchin. It's like if the local Department of Health abruptly calls a news conference to declare the water is safe to drink, because telling people not to panic seems to be the best way to get people to panic.
Absolutely.
I think. Is he overstating this?
No, I don't think he is. Actually, it would be funny if it wasn't tragic. I mean, the one thing we have been sure about is that U.S. banks, big U.S. banks, have gotten their balance sheets in order over the last 10 years. They're actually very safe. So, okay, fact check. Banks are in good shape.
Okay, that does. I told you, stop fact checking.
I know. Are we in a post-fact world?
Yes, we are.
We are. Okay, officially. So that's. I mean, it is incredibly bizarre that he took that move. I can only think that in light of everything the president has done the last few days, and in particular calling into question Jay Powell and the Fed, I mean, that's so destabilizing. So I'm sure Mnuchin is looking for whatever way he can to reassure the market. But the fact is, nobody wants to see the president calling into question what the Fed is doing. The Fed is supposed to be apolitical. There were already going to be plenty of market jitters right now to begin with, by the way. You know, we've known interest rates are going to be going up for some time. We're 10 years into a recovery cycle, which is historically when you start to see slowdowns. So there's the U.S.-China trade issue still bubbling. So there was already going to be turbulence at this period. To create more with this drama is just, it's a crazy thing.
Yeah, so down 350 points.
Yeah.
That is all Steve Mnuchin today, says Rana Faruhar. Let me ask you this. You mentioned Jerome Powell. This is another person that the president seems adding to his list of grievances and that he's angry at right now. Jerome Powell is the Fed chairman, and he's been asking his advisors about his legal authority to fire Jerome Powell. He also, the president, just tweeted moments ago about the Fed. The only problem our economy has is the Fed. They don't have a feel for the market. They don't understand necessary trade wars or strong dollars or even Democrat shutdowns over borders. The Fed is like a powerful golfer who can't score because he has no touch. He can't putt.
Well, I love the putting metaphor. I think that tells you that the president wants to be on the green at Mar-a-Lago. But, you know, what's amazing to me about this is that Donald Trump likes to use the stock markets as a proxy for the health of the real economy. That has never been the case, okay? We've been disconnected. The real economy, Main Street and Wall Street have been disconnected for many, many years. And in fact, that's one of the reasons that the Fed wants to raise rates right now. They think there's too much froth in the market, that stocks are too high, that there's too much corporate debt. There's record corporate debt, by the way, which is one of the things that they want to deal with. Now, they've also said that they're going to be very data dependent, that they're going to look at this really carefully. But this was a debate that was happening way before Donald Trump parachuted in and either tried to take credit for the markets or now criticize the Fed for tanking them.
But I do
incorrectly, by the way.
But I do want to ask you, he's asking advisors if he has legal authority. So far, at least they say he does not.
Yeah.
But what legal authority or not,
yeah,
he could try it.
Yeah.
If he did, what would that do?
That would be a real disaster. I mean, I honestly can't think of anything more apocalyptic for the markets right now than if the president were to really try and push for Powell's removal. If there's been any institution, and we're, by the way, just to step back, we're at a period where there is trust in no institution right now.
So
not in government,
right,
not in business. You know, media has been hit. But if there is an institution that does have a lot of trust, I think, in many places, it is the central banks of the world. They've done a lot in the last 10 years to bolster the economy. They are apolitical. They're one of the few bodies that can really kind of be above the squabbling that we're seeing not only in Washington but in other capitals around the world. And it's so important right now that that not be compromised.
So stay tuned. Great
to see
you. Good to see you, Radha. Thank you so
Thank
much.
You.